ابني. Again, brothers, there's a lot of gaps still in the back. Please, please keep coming forward. Any gap that you see, please fill up. Inshallah, we'll not start this a lot until all the gaps are filled up. Alright, so inshallah, the Eid Salah, contrary to the Jum'ah Salah, where we have the khutbah first and then we have the Salah, we will inshallah be doing the khutbah, the Eid Salah first and then we will do the khutbah. And both of them are wajib to attend. They're both together. Just how the khutbah for Jum'ah is linked with the Salah, just like this, the khutbah of Eid is linked with the Salah of Eid is linked with the khutbah which comes after it. Inshallah, we will be performing the Eid Salah with extra takbirat, according to the riwayah of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. So it will be six extra takbirat. I will say the takbir of the tahrim on the first takbir, and after that, I will do three extra takbirs. And then I will recite the surah, Surah al-Fatiha, we'll recite another surah, and then we'll go to Rukur, Sujood, come back up for the second raka'ah, the same normal way, no extra takbirat. However, when we go down for Rukur, right before we go for Rukur, in the second raka'ah, we'll do three more extra takbirat, and then we'll go for Rukur, inshallah. So,
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Wa lillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La
stand shoulder to shoulder, slow ra'atadi. Salatu al-Eid. Allah Akbar. Allah Akbar. Allah الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. والضحى والليل إذا سجى، ما ودعك ربك وما قلى، وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى، ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى. ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى، ووجدك ضالا فهدى، ووجدك عائلا فأغنى، فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر، وأما السائل فلا تنهر، وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ولله الحمد. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ولله الحمد. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ولله الحمد. الحمد لله. الله سبحانه وتعالى through his blessings and his mercy has allowed us to witness the day of Nahr, the 10th day of Dhu-Hijjah, the day after the best day of the year, which was Yawm al-Arafah. And this is the day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I do the takbirat, because of the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided you, the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put inside of you the light of Islam and the light of Iman. And on this day, what are we celebrating? celebrating, again, everything goes back to our deen. Even in our celebrations, it goes back to this pure religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's the sacrifices of our grandfather Ibrahim alayhi salam, a man whose entire family went through sacrifices, whose entire family put their desires on the side for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We see the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him as a khalid, as a very close and beloved friend. Why? Because Ibrahim alayhi salam never put anybody in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when they come to take to their relationship. He understood the importance of the relationship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He understood the importance of the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From a young age, when he told his father, and he asked his father, and he asked him not in a way to disrespect his father, but because he just wanted to understand, يَا أَبْتِ لِمَا تَعْبُدُ هَذِهِ الْأَصْنَامِ Oh my father, why are you worshipping these idols? When he questioned his father, and his father told him to get out of the house, and his father threatened him, he said, Salamu alayhi, he said, peace be unto you, my father. I will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. From the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the young age, tested him with one of the most, the strongest bond, the bond of parents and children. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him there. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to see who Ibrahim would put first. And he put Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. Then when Ibrahim alayhi salam continued on this path of Tawheed and he continued his da'wah, he asked his people, why they were worshiping things that could not see, things that could not hear. And again, what happened? They threatened him and they were threatened to throw him in such a huge fire. And the Prophet mentioned that this was not just any normal fire. We may read in the books that it was a normal fire. He said this fire was so huge that if a bird were to fly over, the bird would become roasted. This is how huge and humongous this fire they had created. And to throw him in this fire, they had to catapult him into the fire. And while he was being catapulted into the fire, Jibril Salam came and he said, Oh Ibrahim, I'm here to help you. And he said, Ibrahim alayhi salam, again, his relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being the most special relationship from amongst the ulul azm, being the Muslim, and being from the great prophets. He asked Jibril a very important question. He said, did you volunteer to come or did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent you? He said, I came, I volunteered, I asked Allah that I come and help you. And he said, I do not need you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not for me, the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam showed his true faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No matter the circumstances, no matter the situation, no matter whatever dilemma he was in, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being the Khalid, who controls everything in this universe, he changed the quality of the fire. The fire we know, took it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed the quality of this fire because Ibrahim alayhi salam, again, his life is in danger now. He tested it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested it, he passes the test. Later on, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants the family a infant boy named Ismail and his wife Hajar. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides, Oh Ibrahim, test him. Oh Ibrahim, this time we can test it again. This family that you have been asking for years, I want you to go and leave them in the desert. I want you to go and place it in a place where there is no habitation, where there is no human being living. Out in the wada, out in the wild, out in the valleys of Mecca. At the time, there was no habitation. Nobody was living in Mecca. People began living in Mecca after Ismail and Hajar alayhi salam came there. And Ibrahim alayhi salam went. He took his family. And he left them there. And his wife Hajar, she was panicking. And then she asked, Al-Amr Abdullah bihada, has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what do you do with this? What do you to do this? And he got on his head. And then she said that again, the family will not be wasted. Now the family is showing trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, despite the circumstances. It's not easy to be stuck in this type of a situation, but yet you still put your unwavering trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then later on, and then we know what happened after that. Then again, when Ibrahim alayhi salam finally had permission from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reunite with his son. And you reunited with his son at such a tender age. When he reached the age where Ismail was able to run along with his father. That is one of the most tender age a father and son can share with each other. And those fathers here that know how beloved that age is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells orders Ibrahim once again, O Ibrahim, again, you are the Khalil of Allah. You want to be the Khalil of Allah, well then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test you and see, are you truly deserving of this? And in a dream, we know Ibrahim alayhi salam, he sacrificed his son. And now, subhanAllah, look at the son. Look at how righteous the son is at such a young age. The hikmah that the son has. Ya abati, if I will not talk about it, so inshallah, in the salami. Oh, my father, when he came to him, he said, oh, my son, I see a dream that I'm starting you. He said, oh, my father, do whatever you have been commanded. Verily, you will find me from the ones who are patient. And then we see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala went. When he saw that Ibrahim alayhi salam without any hesitation was ready to sacrifice his son, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and now Ibrahim, you have passed the test. Now you have passed the test. لَمَّا أَسْلَمَ وَقَلَّهُ لِلْجَمِيلِ. When they both submitted, أَسْلَمَ, when both of them, the son and the father submitted, the entire family, and what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored Ibrahim alayhi salam. He gave him the honor of rebuilding his da'wah. He gave him the honor of becoming the Abu al-Anbiya, the father of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the honor of being his khalid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him such a high honor. But why was this high honor given? Because of his unwavering trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we look through the progeny of Ibrahim alayhi salam, all these prophets who come, Musa alayhi salam, the way he was tested time and time again. Not just with Fir'aun, not just with the situation where he was in. But then after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved the Bani Israel, Musa alayhi salam, he went through a lot of tests with the Bani Israel as well. He went through a lot of tests of fish with the Bani Israel as well. And we look at, in the last at least, we look at the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sacrifices and the amount of tests that him and his companions went through. But they stood steadfast and they saw the model, role model of Rasulullah alayhi wa sallam. And they did not let that compromise their principles, no matter what the situation was. Unfortunately, in respect to brothers, elders, and sisters, we also sacrifice in this day and age. But we are sacrificing this deen, we are sacrificing the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whether it's outward or inward. That is what, unfortunately, this is what our sacrifices become. We have sacrificed our principles as well. However, on this day, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us to celebrate, why is He telling us to celebrate? Because we are celebrating the sacrifices of those who paved the way for us to be sitting here and being able to say this, la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, we thank you, and we cannot be shukr of you enough that you have created us from the ummah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you have created us from those who understand your wahdaniyah, from those who acknowledge the hakmah of your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And my dear respected brothers, elders, and sisters, as we celebrate today, let's not forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has basically, through the Sunnah of Ibrahim, the Hajj which takes place. The rituals of the Hajj which were taught to us by Rasulullah are all from the time of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And from there we have the Udhiyah. And in this day and age, the scholars say, whoever can afford it, it is wise for the Prophet to do the Udhiyah. And even if you cannot, even if you may not be able to afford it, it is recommended you strive to at least get into some portion. Even if you split an animal with somebody, because it is not the meat or the blood which reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is the taqwa. It is your willing to spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what the sacrifice of the Udhiyah the significance of it, my dear respected brothers, elders, and sisters. Let us stop compromising on our deen. Let us stop compromising on the normal fara'id that we have. Let us stop compromising on the salawat, the five salawat that we have to do. MashaAllah, such a beautiful crowd. However, it is so hard to get our masajid filled on 5 billion prayers. However, we cry and we think about that. We look at the apathy of the ummah. And we look at the destruction of the ummah. But yet, we ourselves are slaughtering and sacrificing the usur. Ya Abi Rishad, brothers, elders, and sisters. This is the dua that we have to make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the dua that we make to Ya Allah. Allow us not to put anything before you. Just how Ibrahim alayhi salam never put anybody before you. And how he was willing to listen to you and he was willing to sacrifice any desire he had for your sake. وقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كثيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. قال الله تعالى في قرآنه المجيد وفرقانه الحميد إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على نبينا محمد وعلى آل نبينا محمد وبارك وسلم. اللهم صل على نبينا محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. اللهم وحد صفوف المسلمين اللهم وحد صفوف المسلمين اللهم تقبل منا صلاتنا وصيامنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا وتلاوتنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر المسلمين في فلسطين وفي افريقيا يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. On behalf of the PIC and myself, I'd like to wish all you guys عيد مبارك كل عام وأنتم بخير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Inshallah, the brothers can use the front entrance to the exit right here. Inshallah, it will be opened up. The front entrance can be used for the brothers, and the sisters can use the back.